our religion also.
Yes.
So whether Indonesia and Pakistan could cooperate on that, of course, because we have already the mechanism. We have the joint working group on international counter-terrorism. Yeah. And the joint working group had met once, and I think we have to have another meeting. But at that time, the government of Indonesia proposed, and now we are waiting for the response of the government of Pakistan about the timing of the meeting.
And can you tell us that your country is also facing the same challenge like Pakistan, like the law and order and this non-state actors activities in your country?
Non-state actors, of course, now terrorism is not only a problem for Indonesia and Pakistan, as you said.
It's a whole international community.
It's a problem of the whole international community. Indonesia also a victim of terrorism. We had the Bali bombing at the time, and I think last month we have also the series of we witness the series of terrorist attack in Baghdad, in Jordan, and then in Turkey, and then in Saudi Arabia. We had also in Indonesia in Solo. So we have the same concern about that, and we have also problem, but the government is really committed, the army, the police is really committed how to curb the terrorism and extremism. And of course, we always promote the spirit of Islam as rahmatan lil alamin. That is very principle that Indonesian is always uphold.
Sir, how do you see the sacrifices of our armed forces and people of Pakistan bravely against the terrorism? You know, our country has lost billions of in terms of economy, and more than 60,000 people have lost their lives in the war against terror. But how do you see now the law and order situation in Pakistan as comparatively with some years back? And especially, how do you see this ongoing military operation Zarbazam against terrorism?
Yeah, I really appreciate what has been and what has been done by the military and the government of Pakistan to improve the better political and security situation in Pakistan. And as I told you, I've been here for 4 months, but I noticed that this is a significant improvement in the security condition in Pakistan in terms of stability. And it also directly contribute to the economic situation in Pakistan. I think as far as I know, now is the best condition comparing to the previous in Pakistan in terms of GDP, in terms of foreign exchange reserve, now is the biggest in the history of Pakistan. It is because of the better security condition.
Exactly.
And I really appreciate what has been done by the military of Pakistan. And of course, I do agree with you that Pakistan has been the victim of terrorism. And I also appreciate that the government of Pakistan, as well as the military, is really committed to continue the operation by formulating the national plan of action.
National action plan.
Yes, national action plan.
And we have a consensus among the military and political leadership as well to root out terrorism.
This is very, very...
It's a milestone, I think.
Yes,
it's
a milestone. Because that's very important for the CPEC also. CPEC is very strategic for Pakistan in terms of economy and national stability.
Excellent. Exactly, I was about to ask the question about the CPEC after this, and you just mention about this. How do your country see this, a very historic Pakistan economic corridor? And does your country leadership is thinking to be become part of this project as well?
Yeah, CPEC, as many high-ranking official, even the president mentioned that CPEC is the game changer in the Pakistan.
Not only Pakistan, yeah, but in this region.
Yes. And it is the biggest investor in the history of Pakistan. It's $46 billion.
Yes.
It's very important. And of course, it's not easy. It's not easy because we have also experience in Indonesia on how to build the infrastructure. We need a huge amount of money. But I do believe with the very strong commitment of the Pakistani government and Pakistani military to make the situation better about the security, so CPEC it will become a reality in this region. And Indonesia as a country, of course, we willing to cooperate with Pakistan. As I told you, it's not only in terms of trade, but also in the infrastructure development cooperation, meaning it's part of the CPEC project.
So you are hopeful that this project will be completed with the due framework of times, and especially all Muslim countries also can avail this opportunity?
Yes, it's automatically. If the CPEC successful, and then the trickle-down effect to the economic and social development will be robust, excellent. So then all country will come to Pakistan to do the business, to be part of the progress of the Pakistan.
And sir, do you certify with the role of Pakistan regarding stability and peace efforts in this region, as this region is considered to be a very sensitive region?
Yes.
As you know, that situation in Afghanistan is not satisfactory. Mm-hmm. We have not coordination with our neighboring country, India. So do you think that Pakistan's role for strengthening the peace and stability in this region is satisfactory? How do you see your country?
I think the stability of the region cannot be created by one particular country, like in our region in ASEAN. It need the work together, and the responsibility of the stability for particular region is goes to country reside in the region. So the role of Pakistan, I think Pakistan will be hosting the next SAARC summit.
Yes, at the end of this year.
End of this year. This, yes. I think, should be used as a strategic platform on how to bring all the participants into same vision about the importance of creating, promoting, and nurturing peace and stability in the region. Because this region is has a huge potential in terms of population. If combine the Indian population, Bangladeshi, and then Pakistan, and then the Central Asia.
It's half of the world population.
Yes.
It's more than that, I think.
Yes, it's very important. That is why all countries, I think, should restrain from any approach which is not productive or counterproductive to the objective of promoting peace and stability. That's very important. Because by having more stable region, it give equal opportunity to all countries to pursue the development. So the next summit of the SAARC
is very important.
Is very critically important to be the platform, forum for all participants to come to the same vision on how to...
With a consensus approach.
Yes, consensus approach is very important.
That's very important.
Because we in ASEAN, we cannot playing the zero-sum game approach. It will not long last But by having consensus, meaning everybody is part of the program and the ownership to promote the stability also has in the same spirit and the same level of responsibility.
And lastly, sir, any message that you want to give to the people of Pakistan?
Yeah, of course, since now it's still in the spirit of Idul Fitri, so I have to say Eid Mubarak for all Pakistani, and I wish all the best for all Pakistani. And as Indonesian ambassador to Pakistan, I'm happy staying here in Islamabad, because Pakistan is a great country and hospitable country and warm people, rich culture, and I don't have any problem also with the food. I enjoy Pakistani food and culture, and hope I also get the support from Pakistani in our effort to promote bilateral cooperation between Bardoli country, Indonesia and Pakistan. So once again, all the best for all Pakistani, and thank you, Mr. Malik Mansur, for having me in the Diplomatic Enclave TV program.
Excellency, the Minister of Indonesia, His Excellency Iwan Amri, I'm highly grateful to you for sparing the time for our programs. And as you know that His Excellency, being a very outstanding and professional diplomat, he shed a light on the bilateral relations, economic, trade, political, economics, cultures, and the role of ASEAN and Pakistan's role regarding stability and peace efforts in this region. So very comprehensive conversation that we have in this program, and we hope to see you sometime next with a fresh question and your efforts in this program as well in the future.
Thank you. So thank you for having me once again.
Thank you very much, sir. Thanks. Viewers, this is the end of program. Thank you very much.